The beauty with CSU is because we have so many groups and facility and researchers with different disciplines, we can all work together.
What that allows us to do is it allows us to move more rapidly and move in parallel.
We have to show conclusively and definitively that that virus cannot replicate and cause disease in the recipients. We're currently working on developing a vaccine for SARS-CoV-2, the virus that causes COVID-19. We've taken a biotechnology platform that's meant for pathogen reduction of blood products for transfusion and repurposed it in a way to inactivate the virus. So we're using riboflavin and UV light. The reason we use riboflavin is because it interacts with the nucleic acids of pathogens. We think specifically the guanine bases in the RNA and the DNA. When you use a photosensitizer like riboflavin, then those breaks in the DNA or the RNA become irreversible. It can't repair itself and then renders it inactive for perpetuity.
The process works by disrupting that nucleic acid ability to replicate, but preserves the antigen-presenting proteins that are present in the virus. And that's what you want to have if you're trying to develop an effective vaccine. You want it to look as much as possible like the native wild-type virus.
So that the immune system can recognize it as such and mount that immune response that we're looking for in a vaccine.
And then from there, if you see promising results, you want to move it to an in vivo model. This will allow you to look at efficacy. It'll allow you to look at the safety of the vaccine. And if you pass those hurdles, everything's still moving forward. That's when you start doing the mass production.
You need an understanding of how you produce a vaccine candidate, manufacture it, scale it up. That's what Biomark does in terms of translating the ideas from the basic science into the practical application of manufacturing a product. And that's a unique aspect, I think, of what we have here within Colorado State University. You have to think about how you translate that knowledge into producing tens of millions, hundreds of millions, potentially billions of vaccines.